Israel is not your state. It is Zionist. And this is your government.
For over 34 years now, this has been a recurring face to tourists who on daily basis throng the Lafayette Park directly opposite the White House in Washington, D.C. A peace, freedom, and justice for mankind advocate, Concepcion Picciotto, a Spanish by birth, immigrated to the United States at the age of 18. She had met and joined forces with William Thomas of blessed memory in the anti-warfare struggle called White House Anti-Nuclear Peace Vigil. All day, all night, she is here calling global attention to the dangers and harmful effects of nuclear warfare and vowing never to give up the struggle until world leaders hearken to her voice by sincerely halting the spate of nuclear weapon production and use, particularly by the world superpowers and emerging ones. Live by the bomb, die by the bomb is her focus.
In the stranger future, the man is supposed to go for education, taking and cutting the budget on education. No, we got to stop Israel terrorism, and that's what Eisenhower called. A peaceful revolution is the only solution, the only one who told the truth.
She has lived in this makeshift tent for 34 years now and had at different times had running battles with law enforcement agencies, particularly the National Park Service, which by law does not allow protesters to the front of the White House to leave their protest materials like posters, banners, and others behind. Ms. Picciotto survives on the goodwill of tourists to the park, and when recently members of the All Progressives Congress APC were on an advocacy rally to the White House, some of them offered to help her fix her already battered makeshift tent as the winter cold was biting hard. Ironically, for the 34 years she has sat in front of the White House, seemingly watching over the most powerful seat of government in the world, Ms. Picciotto has not had the privilege of meeting with a single American president. She is 78 years of age and does not appear to give up the struggle anytime soon. From Washington, D.C., Adesina Anidugbe, Ogtv News.